Today, we're going to be looking at an invasive species that is found in our Lower Hudson Prism region that's really obvious this time of year. We're taping this the third week of May in Dutchess County, New York, and we are taking a look behind me at the purple flowers that are now appearing of wisteria. And there's actually a couple of different types of invasive wisteria that we are found in our region. There is Japanese wisteria and Chinese wisteria. And this video will teach you some of the differences for how to tell them apart. But you can take a look at its distinctive purple flowers. These should be out from late May to early June in our region. And you can see that behind this forest edge behind me, wisteria can grow in and amongst, like almost have a shrub-like growth pattern to it and kind of overtake some of the other shrubs that you see behind it. But as you see in this tree behind me, this big pine tree, it is also known for wrapping around trees and then climbing up actually pretty high. And so that's how it kind of does its damage, by girdling a lot of the trees in which it's growing. Remember that it's a woody vine, and so it needs another structure to wrap around. And so it can climb up these trees, and it depends on which direction that is actually twining around the tree as to whether it's a Japanese or Chinese version or species. So there's a couple of different features that we can look out for. And again, it can grow in a shrub-like fashion or as a vine that grows up and above trees. So we'll take a closer look at some of the key features. Here we can see a closer look at the clusters of flowers of wisteria. They almost dangle off the plant itself, almost like grapes will cluster together and dangle off of a grapevine. Well, this is the wisteria flowers kind of have that very similar appearance. And I wanted to zoom in on the vine itself. You see how it's wrapping around this oak tree here? And you notice, like from my finger, how it's twining from the bottom left up right. And that is actually means when it's twining in that direction, bottom left to upper right, that it is Chinese wisteria. If it happened to be twining up whatever tree or shrub or whatever is climbing up in this direction, so from bottom right to upper left, then it would be the Japanese species or Japanese wisteria. So that's just kind of a cool difference between the two types of invasive species that we have in our region of wisteria, and just a really closer look at those dangling flower clusters. Now we'll take a look at the leaves. So wisteria has a compound leaf structure and is pinnately compound. And if you can take a look at this, in terms of the leaflets coming off, you'll notice that they're coming off opposite of one another. And if you zoom in really close, you can see that there's a little bit of fine hairs on each of the edges. And it really comes to a point. As these leaves mature, you'll start to notice, you can kind of see it from the side angle here, that there's a wavy appearance to each of those leaflets. So that's another key way to look at it, a kind of wavy compound leaf, that the leaflets have this like a little bit of a wave to them. And you can tell that it's compound. You can look for where the bud is and the new bud on the next year. If this will zoom in on my finger here. Well, the new buds are actually towards the base of this. And then up now you can see it in the background where the new buds are growing. And you know, just again, this wavy-like appearance to each of the leaflets and with finish hairs on it, especially when it's younger like this. So that's just some of the other key features. And again, just taking a look at the flower cluster. So looking for these purplish flowers, they can grow both as a shrub-like fashion or really start like winding up a tree. As you can see as it is persisting and winding up this tree here. So be on the lookout for wisteria in May and early June in our area. And if you do happen to see it, be sure to post to iNaturalist and let us know where it is being distributed so we can continue tracking it in the Lower Hudson Prism region. Here's a lookalike alert. What we're looking at here is a lilac shrub. And you can see why it is confused with wisteria, because it's got these purple flower clusters that are growing on the terminal ends of the branches. But there's a couple of key features that you'll know you're looking at lilac and not wisteria. So first of all, if you take a look at the leaf shape, it's not at anything like wisteria. So these lilacs are known for their sort of almost like heart-shaped leaves. And so not that kind of wavy compound leaf that we're seeing in wisteria. It's interesting, you know, lilacs are blooming at the same time as wisteria does, and the flowers can look kind of similar. And lilac is a non-native species, just like wisteria, but it is not considered to be invasive in our region. It tends to stay where it's planted. and not expand and kind of impact our local biodiversity. And that's unlike wisteria, which really has negatively impacted a lot of our native species that we are trying to protect. But just another look at the lilac shrub and just ways of telling the difference between them, looking in lilacs for heart-shaped leaves versus wisteria as the wavy compound leaf structure.